What's up, you guys? So I'm so excited for today's video because, as you can see by the title, we're doing some festival makeup looks. I'm going to Coachella in about 3 weeks now, I think, and I'm so excited. I've been looking at like my Pinterest a lot and just looking up inspo for like makeup and outfit ideas. So I'm putting together this video to show you guys some possible festival looks and possibly ones that I might be wearing myself. Also, if you have not noticed, I have a beautiful plain white background and some beautiful light, so now I can film wherever I want, whenever I want. This will definitely help with the quality of my videos, and it's especially nice for like makeup tutorials. So this is the first video using this new setup. But yeah, I'm actually gonna be showing you guys two different makeup looks. This one, which is a more girly, fairy-esque type of look. And for the second look, I'm gonna do more of like a smoky, intense eye and just more color, I guess. So for both of the looks, I'm actually gonna be using some ColourPop cosmetics. ColourPop was so kind and they actually sent me these products to try out. I'm gonna be testing out the Hello Kitty Hello Pretty kit and also the Amanda Steele Weekend Warrior eyeshadow palette. I'm not getting paid to like review these products or whatever. I'm just testing them out, telling you guys what I think, and all opinions are my own. So yeah, I'm so excited to play around with these. And without further ado, if you wanna see how I put together this look and another music festival inspired makeup look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so to start off this makeup look, I already have my face moisturized and I'm just gonna spray some of my Mario Badescu facial spray to give my skin some extra hydration. Ah, it feels so good. Now I'm gonna be going in with my CoverFX mattifying primer, and we just need this because we want our makeup to last all day during the music festival. So I'm just gonna put that on my cheeks, on my nose, and my forehead, because that's where I get oily. Next, I'm gonna be going in with this foundation. It's the IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better CC Cream, and I just recently got this after hearing so many good things about it, and it's awesome. This one's perfect because it's super lightweight and it has SPF 50, which is perfect because we're gonna be out in the sun all day, so we need to, you know, protect our faces. And I'm just gonna go in and like rub that in with my fingers, because I feel like that's how you get the most of the product. Usually I would use my little like Real Technique sponge, but I feel like it just soaks up so much product. And this was really expensive, I'm not gonna lie. But I do think it was a good investment, so yeah. Oh my god, I love this product so much. It feels so good, and it's like the perfect amount of coverage. I really like it. And then I'm actually gonna be going in with a little bit more of that. Just go over some like little blemishes that I might have. And so now that my face is all nice and even, I'm gonna go in with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. I just bought a new one and I'm so excited to use it under my eye, my chin, my nose, and just a little on my forehead. Just gonna blend that out with my trusty little Real Technique sponge. Oh, I love the brightening effect of it. Just makes you look so alive, and you know, we want to look lively and happy to be at the music festival, so this is a crucial step. So to lock all that in, we're just gonna go in with this loose setting powder from Maybelline. It's flying everywhere. While that's baking, I'm just gonna go in and do my eyebrows. Found it. So I'm gonna be using NYX Tinted Brow Mascara. I've had this for so long and I've neglected using it until recently because, I don't know, I really like it because it just looks a lot more natural than like drawing in my entire eyebrow. So I'm just kind of filling in the ends of my eyebrow, and then later on I'm gonna go in with a pencil to fill in the front. I think I've converted it to just using brow mascara for the majority of my eyebrows because it's a lot faster, and I find that when I just draw on my entire eyebrow, it just looks, it looks too perfect, you know? Just gonna go in with my Benefit Goof Proof pencil just to like lightly fill in the front of my eyebrow. Brush them out a little, make them a little bit messy. Now I think my powder has been sitting on for long enough, so I'm just gonna brush that off. And we're left with a beautifully brightened face. I love it. Now I'm just gonna go in and set the rest of my face, and I'm gonna be using this Stay Matte, Rimmel Stay Matte Pressed Powder. I'm just gonna take that on my brush and just kinda lightly pat that everywhere. If you're at a music festival, chances are you're gonna be sweating and you're gonna be feeling gross, but you know, we're gonna try to stay as matte as possible. Alright, so let's move on to the eyes. So I'm just gonna go in with my Too Faced Shadow Insurance eyeshadow primer. Because again, we want our makeup to stay all day. So for this makeup look, I'm actually gonna go in with this ColourPop Hello Kitty Hello Pretty kit. Try saying that 5 times really fast. I've tried ColourPop Cosmetics and I'm a fan, a big fan, especially of like their Super Shock eyeshadows. So this kit actually comes with 3 of the Super Shock shadows. It comes with Juicy Apple, Sticker Sheet, and Bento Box. And then it also comes with a blush called Fun With Friends, and then Yummy Cookies, which is the highlight. And then 2 lip products. So I'm not gonna be using all of these for this look, but I will definitely be using some of them. So as a base, I'm gonna be going in with Bento Box, and this is just a really pretty light white gold shade, and I'm just gonna go with my fingers because I feel like it works the best when you do. So I'm just gonna put that like all over my lid pretty much. Just because this look is gonna be super like glittery and fresh and girly. So I really like this. It's super pigmented and super shimmery and glittery. Perfect for music festivals. It's all about the glitter and gold and all that cute stuff. And then next I'm actually gonna use the highlight shade Yummy Cookies. That just sounds so yummy. So I'm gonna focus this more like on the outer part of my eye. Go right on top of the other shadow. And then I kinda wanna darken up the eye a little bit, so I'm gonna go in with this shadow called Sticker Sheet. This is just a dark brown. And I'm gonna put that in my crease and use a brush, not my finger, because we wanna blend that in, you know? Pack that on. I really like ColourPop stuff just because it's super blendable. Like, it's really good quality makeup, but it's actually really cheap. So again, I'm gonna go in with the Juicy Apple, and I'm just gonna put that like right back in the center of my eye just so that it brightens it up again. Just because I think after putting so many other shadows on top, it kind of, the color just, it was lost, you know. The sparkles are kind of going everywhere, but you know, I meant to do it. Next, I'm gonna line my eyes with this Wet n Wild felt tip eyeliner. It's a dark brown, and I just wanted to do something like a little bit less intense than a black liner. Sometimes I just go halfway and just have it blend into my lash line just so that the wing just looks like it's just naturally there. I don't know if that makes sense. We're gonna just go in with some mascara, and I'm gonna be using this one from Maybelline Falsies Push Up Drama. I'm gonna put on a very natural pair of lashes after this, so just a light little coat of this. These are just some lashes from Ardell. I got these at like Target. These ones just look super like wispy and natural. So, you know, I'm a fan. Ooh, I skipped a very important step. I'm just gonna put some of this dark brown eyeshadow underneath just to darken everything out and make it all balanced, you know? And I'm just gonna finish up the rest of my face, put some bronzer on. I'm gonna be using my trusty Smashbox contour kit, and I'm just gonna be using this shade. I'm gonna be putting that on my cheekbones. Ooh, yeah. When we're out in the sun, we wanna look nice and tan, so we're putting some color back into our face. Also, just add some more dimension, make us look all sun-kissed. Oh yes. Next step, I'm gonna go in with this very pink blush. I know it looks a little bit intense, so I'm kind of like nervous about this. I don't know. I'm gonna go in with a very light hand because I don't want this to be like too intense. So just gonna kind of like pat that in like that, right on the apples of my cheeks. And I like it. It's not like too pink, it looks nice. I really like this. What was that accent? Oh, this was in the shade Fun With Friends, by the way. Next, I'm gonna go in again with my Mario Badescu facial spray and just spritz my face. Now, I can put on some highlight. I'm actually using the gold eyeshadow as a highlight just because this one's like super bright and I feel like it looks really nice. Is that gonna come off? Go and put some on my nose. Oh, that's really shiny. We can go crazy with the sparkles for music festival. It's fine, it's fine. Also gonna put that in my inner corner. Oh, whoa, that was a lot. Okay, so I usually like to put my highlight after I like spritz my face really quick just so that the highlight sticks better. You know, it makes sense, right? So I'm just gonna go in with this Burt's Bees tinted lip balm because if it's hot out, our lips are gonna be chapped, and I think tinted lip balms are the way to go. because it's really easy to reapply and we don't want dry lips in the desert, you know. This is in the color Hibiscus and it's just a nice pinky color. And I'm actually gonna go in with this lip. Oh, on top of this, I'm actually gonna go in with one of the lip products from the Hello Kitty kit. And this is the Ultra Glossy Lip in the shade KT. And it's just a very shimmery lip gloss and it looks super, super blingy, so. I like that. Yes. This would look good on top of like any lip color because it's just a sheer lip gloss with like some goldish tint to it. Whenever I go to any event, whether it be a concert or a music festival, I always like to add a little bit more blingage to my face. So I'm actually going to be using these really pretty jewels. These are like just adhesive stickers and there's so many colors to choose from. You can get these off of Amazon. I can link those down below for you. You guys have probably all heard of like the faux freckle trend going on, but I'm actually going to be doing some faux freckles with some rhinestones. So I'm just going to be placing them randomly on my cheek. And ooh. So everything is done now. So I'm just going to go in and set my entire face with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Okay, so that is this completed look. I really like how it turned out, and I think that it's super, super pretty. Okay, so for this part of the video, I'm gonna be showing you a whole nother makeup look, but this time it's gonna be a little bit darker and smokier. I'm gonna have a little bit more color. All around, it's just gonna be a lot more intense. I'm just gonna have the same face makeup as the last look. I'm just gonna change up the eyes. So for this look, I'm gonna be using this palette right here. This is the Amanda Steele Weekend Warrior palette, and this palette comes with 4 different eyeshadows, and these are more of a pressed powder, as you can see. They're all very matte, kind of muted colors, I would say. I don't know. I think that this will make for a really nice smoky eye, so I'm gonna play around with this. Also, this hair is just really bothering me. Just throw it in the back. So I already have primer on my eyes, and I'm just gonna go in with this shade right here. It's called Harley. Looks like a good base color, so I'm just gonna be packing that onto this brush right here, tapping off the excess, and just kind of swooping that over my entire lid. The payout is really good for this eyeshadow. And I really like how the color looks. Ooh, it's like a taupey grayish color. Next, I'm gonna go in with this very dark teal color. It's called Burnout. I'm just gonna take that on like a flat shader brush and just pack that onto my lid pretty much. Ooh, look at that. One thing that I don't like about this palette so far is that it doesn't have a mirror right here, which is like kind of inconvenient. But other than that, like the packaging itself is pretty nice. Color is really intense, but I think it's perfect for this look. I'm like really packing this in. Damn. I'm gonna go back with my big fluffy brush and just try to like blend that all together because it's looking a little harsh right now. Okay, so that's pretty blended, and I'm gonna go in with this last purple shade right here called Chopper, and I'm gonna put that in the outer corner of my eye, and I'm just gonna drag that inward. And I feel like the teal and the purple kind of makes a really nice dark blue, so I kind of like that. And one more time, I'm just gonna blend that all together. So now that all of this is just super dark, I'm gonna go in with a blue liner and line the bottom lash line. This is a gel eyeliner from Rimmel London in the color Blue Steel. That's so funny that this is called Blue Steel and then I'm using the Amanda Steele palette. It worked. I'm gonna also go in with my Stila liquid eyeliner and just do a wing. So I added my very intense winged liner, and I'm actually gonna go in with another eyeliner from Rimmel, and this is actually a lighter blue, and I'm just gonna put that in the inner part of my eye just so it's like dark blue to light blue. Definitely gonna be putting on another fake pair of lashes for this look, but I'm gonna go for a more dramatic lash. I'm gonna be using these. I don't have the box, but these are the Coco lashes. I think they're called the Mila. So I successfully got the lashes on and I, you know, touched up the eyeliner and whatnot. I'm just gonna be adding a little bit of an inner corner highlight. I'm gonna be using Prosketto Pop. Just gonna really pack it in there. Add that to my brow bone. And while we're at it, we might as well add some of that same highlight to our cheeks. yes, this makeup look is definitely a lot more intense than the last one, but music festivals are just like the perfect time to experiment with makeup. Of course, last but not least, we're gonna be adding some more jewels. This time I'm gonna be adding some blue jewels to complement that lower lash line. So I pretty much just kind of went for it. I did a darker blue and a lighter blue, and it matches the blues that I put on my eyes perfectly. So I really like how it turned out. Lastly, I'm just gonna spritz my face with my facial spray and then finish off with my Urban Decay All Nighter spray. My two music festival makeup tutorial type of things. I wanted to show different types of makeup that you could do for a festival, one being a little bit more girly and, you know, natural looking, and the other one being a lot more intense, like this. I've never really done something this dramatic before, but I really love how it turned out, and hopefully you guys like these looks as well. And maybe if you're going to a festival soon, maybe Coachella, hopefully you can take some inspiration from this. But yeah, that's just kind of like my recreation of a typical music festival inspired look. So thank you again to ColourPop for sending me these products for me to try out. I will definitely be using them this year for Coachella, and I'm super excited. Anyways, I know that this video is definitely super long, but I want to thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. That is pretty much the end of this video, so I will see you guys in the next one.